So hockey seems to have its own language, the way folks in and outside the game speak. Plenty of get pucks in deep, given 110% are tossed around a lot. But what are some of the greats like when not talking in cliches? TSN's James Duthie attempted to tell some of those tales. 57 stories from hockey's biggest names is his third book, Beauties, Hockey's Greatest Untold Stories. Happy to have James freshly off the Masters with us over the phone this morning. Good morning, James.
How you doing, Tim?
Good, pal. Let's start with the Masters, because I know you're back in the country quarantining. So what was the Masters like in November?
Weird. It was, from a very selfish standpoint, it was amazing, because the one thing about covering the Masters is it's hard to actually cover the Masters on the golf course. It's like walking into 1910. No cell phones are allowed, no electronic scoreboards, just those old wooden scoreboards. And there's so many people usually that, let's say you want to follow Tiger Woods or Dustin Johnson, you're usually about 20 deep in the crowd and you can see the tip of his cap and that's about it. So with no fans there, it was kind of a golf fan's dream where I could stand, you know, I followed Tiger for 9 holes on Friday and his gallery was his girlfriend and Peyton Manning and me and my buddy. So it was unbelievable to just stand, you know, 20 feet away from them on the tee the entire time and, you know, hear the conversations with caddies. So that part of it was really great. But I know, you know, there and I'm sure at home, it really lacked the roars and those things that we're used to. And it kind of sucks a little bit of the drama out of it.
Were you able to pick up any golf stories for your next book?
I think I got a couple, yes. I was right there when Bryson DeChambeau had that meltdown on the third hole. Boy, he's something else to watch, by the way, hit a golf ball. But, there was a few things. I don't know if there's going to be a golf version of Beauties or what.
What attracts you to a good old hockey tale, James?
You know what I think it is, Tim? More than anything else, I've sat on that panel on TSN for 20 years and have been really lucky to sit next to Hall of Fame players and coaches and insiders. And everybody has great stories. Now, most of the time they don't tell them on TV when they're on my panel. They tell them while we're sitting around eating pizza before the game or something because they don't want to tell them on TV. But I just think everybody loves a great story, and hockey is made for stories more than most sports. And I went to 60 guys and said, tell me if Tim and I and you were in a bar having a couple of beers, then, and we said, what's your favorite story from your career? Just tell me your favorite story. I don't care if it's in a game, if it's in the bar after the game, and that's what basically this is, because I think that's, as hockey fans, in the end, that's what we love the most, right? Is a great story, stuff that you wouldn't see on a normal broadcast or be able to get from a guy.
What would a 15-year-old James say about Bobby Orr calling you to tell you one of his personal stories?
Hey man, a 15-year-old and a 50-something-year-old, it's the same reaction. It was I tell this in the book. When I started writing, I guess a year ago, September, he was the first email that I sent because I wanted to have Gretzky in the book and Bobby Orr and Crosby and McDavid and these guys. And I thought it might be a challenge to get a hold of them. And so I sent the email about 10:30 at night, and 8 a.m. the next day, I get this phone call from an unknown number, and I pick it up, and it's, hey, it's James, it's Bobby. Are you ready to hear my story? And I was kind of in a sheer panic. I didn't know how to tape phone calls at the time, and so my only technical way to do it was to use my wife's phone and put it on speaker and use my voice memo folder. And so my wife was ordering something online, and I was freaking out, yelling at her, going, it's Bobby freaking Orr! I need your phone! And that went on for about 20 minutes of that.
She's like, Bobby who?
We're
running out of time, but we have to get to it. Starts off great because Roberto Luongo, he's a hilarious guy, fantastic Hall of Fame goaltender. But he starts the book off. He did the forward for you. I'm about to get this book off to a crappy start. Can you quickly tell that story for us?
Yeah, very quickly. I think people might be aware of the story but don't know the details, that Luongo had to miss several minutes of overtime of an elimination playoff game because he had some delicate stomach issues, to put it politely. I was worried I'd turn people off early with that, but it's so hilarious, the story. He tells it in vivid detail about sitting on the toilet and hearing the game start and being in an absolute panic. So there's also a story about Luongo's being the golden goalie in 2010 at the Olympics, but I just thought that would be a perfect way for him to open the book.
Is there one that stands out One story out of the 57?
Man, it's like picking your favorite child, and I don't know. I think that what I like most, Tim, if I can not answer that question directly, is everybody will probably buy the book for stories from Gretzky and Crosby and Luongo and such, but there's a lot of stories from people that you don't know. Scott Foster was the emergency goalie before David Ayers. They went in Chicago, and he was an accountant, a beer leaguer, and got to play 15 minutes of an NHL game. Stories like that, I think, are my favorites, that people, you know, sort of the unsung heroes that people have not heard of.
There's a heartfelt story, too. We got to go about the assistant coach of the Humboldt Broncos,
right,
who was not on the bus. And
yeah, there's some laughs and hopefully a few tears along the way.
Right. You know TV, so you probably know that they're yelling in my ear, so we got to go.
I just ignore them, Tim. At a certain point, you just ignore the producers.
Can we do that? Oh, they're yelling louder now. Oh, no. James, congratulations on the book. Beauties, Hockey's Greatest Untold Stories.
Thanks for having me.
Get it where you find books. Thanks, pal.